Back here with Ian Hart, sports columnist, AJ Wood, sports journalist, and we're going to be previewing the Ukraine game. Couldn't get any easier, could it, that fixture on paper? AJ, we start with you. And either Czech Republic or Denmark in the semis, and then what, Spain, Belgium or Italy in the final? Is that how it's going to be? Well, how do you see it against Ukraine?
I think they're a decent side. I think you look at their team, Zinchenko obviously plays for Man City, they won the league, so it's not a bad start. You've got Remchuk up front with Yarmolenko. They both look decent players. Malinovsky, they're a good side. I think England will have too much for them, but they're still going to be... You know what they're going to do. They're going to sit back and try and counter us.
Yeah.
Knock out a competition. And they'll play for a draw and try and catch the counter. So it'll be an interesting game, I think. We know England aren't the greatest low block. You look at the Scotland game. We would have said we should have battered Scotland, shouldn't we, really? But...
Yeah.
We didn't. So on paper, we don't win a game, especially in a knockout competition. Anything can happen. I think we'll have enough, but
I guess it's in Rome as well. So England have been travelling for that game.
You could see what Wembley did for them yesterday. It almost carried them through. The fans were
there.
But in Rome, obviously 5-day quarantine. I don't think there'll be many England fans able to get there. So it'll be a different atmosphere, but I think they'll be strong enough and. Yeah, I think they'll do enough to beat Ukraine and get through to the next round. I think Denmark's going to be a really tough game as well. Even if we win this game, I think Denmark, you can't overlook them. They hammered Wales.
Yeah,
the quality they've got in their side, and also they're being carried by obviously what happened with Christian Eriksen. It's a tough game regardless. I think any game from now is tough. Even if we play Czech Republic again, we've already beaten the Czech Republic. If they beat Denmark, then we play them in the next. But I think Czech Republic is still a tough game.
I think all the paramount is we mustn't take them too lightly because they are quality players. You know, same with Denmark and the Czech Republic. And the thing with the Czech Republic, the easiest thing is, we've beaten them already. So dangerous. This is why, for all his Mr. Beige and his waistcoats and whatever, Southgate, very pragmatic, and he's picking these teams on a match-to-match basis. So it's great. I think, you know, joking apart, we've obviously got to travel to Rome, but this tournament was going to go everywhere, wasn't it? Had we not had the pandemic, it was going to be in all these different cities and it was going to be a celebration of European football. So to a degree, the pandemic has helped England with all these games. Because I don't think the Germany game should have been at England last night, was it? If it had been. But anyway, that's by the by. The home advantage worked last night, very much so. It's a great atmosphere, as I said. There's a lot of expats in Europe, and there's a lot of people. I think you'll be shocked at the amount of England fans when that game kicks off. I think you'll be absolutely... I was shocked by the amount of Germans last night.